You're watching WPBF 25 News at 5 with Tiffany Kenny, Victor Blackwell, and Mike Lyons with your first alert forecast. This is WPBF 25 News at 5.
We continue Commitment 2010 tonight, keeping you informed before you head to the polls.
Sunday, we profiled the Republican in the race for governor, Rick Scott. It was a look at the man behind the policies. We wanted to bring you the similar profile of his opponent, Democrat Alex Sink. Well, her campaign declined because of a scheduling problem.
Well, Sink is crisscrossing the state right now, trying to convince voters that she's the better choice, something that was not so difficult to do during the primary.
From the day she announced her candidacy for governor, Alex Sink was the frontrunner for the Democratic nomination. And on primary night, she became the Democratic nominee with 77% of the vote. A North Carolina native, now living north of Tampa, Sink's candidacy centers around her decades of experience in the private sector and nearly 4 years as Florida's chief financial officer, and how they will make her uniquely qualified to lead.
I've been there long enough to see that the partisanship and the special interests are even worse than you think. I've looked under the hood at the engine, and I can tell you, we need more than just a little tune-up.
In a state that's earned a reputation of political corruption, Sink is proposing a four-part plan for stronger ethics and accountability. But her Republican opponent, Rick Scott, who still has ethical questions of his own to answer, says Sink isn't as politically pure as she wants voters to believe.
Change course with Rick Scott or stay stuck with Alex Sink.
Beyond ethical questions, Sink knows the number one issue for voters this cycle is the economy, specifically jobs. And President Obama and former President Clinton have traveled to Florida to help her make her case.
If you would like to make sure that every vacant job in Florida gets filled in a hurry because there are people like you in places like this, you do not have a choice. You have to vote for Alex Sink for governor.
However, in a very tight race against a successful self-made businessman, Sink has had to force voters to question Scott's record and his trustworthiness.
Rick Scott just can't be trusted with Floridians' money.
Critical ads from both campaigns on business leadership and ethics have kept this a very tight race. And in days, voters will decide who they trust.
And coming up at 6, we'll take a look at the three-pronged approach that Sink appears to be taking to convince voters that she's the better choice to solve Florida's problems.